All right, welcome to Out of Your League for the next week. I am your host, Bo Masher, along with a couple other hosts. First, I'd like to introduce Azalea Akari. Welcome.
Well, hello. Good morning, everybody. I am very excited for this episode and to see all that we're going to learn and then the trivia that we're going to play.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. We had Lamp take out the trivia last week, so we'll be looking to bounce back this week, Azalea.
Yeah, I mean, overall, just playing trivia is pretty fun. I'd like to have a better showing, but in the end, as long as it's a fun time, it'll be all good.
Well, we well, hopefully made the questions a little bit easier this week. But we'll ask Dankest Dad. Are the questions going to be easier this week, Dankest?
No, they are not going to be. I heard some complaints last week that a few contestants were able to answer some questions correctly. And this week, I'm hoping we can rectify that. We have our
Oh man.
hardest batch of questions yet, and Bone Masher and I are up on the mound hoping to pitch a perfect game. So we'll see what happens.
I'm ready.
I'm
I'm
looking
ready.
forward to it. All right. To see who's going to take on Azalea for the Quizmaster title this week, Azalea, would you like to introduce our mystery guests?
Absolutely. We have a pair, a fantastic guest, as always. I will start with the person with the I will start. I'll introduce them in alphabetical order just so I don't get confused. So first up, we have a player who has top who has played in multiple Masters tours and has gotten a top 16 in one of them, hailing from many. He's played about six, I believe it's been six different expansions now, so about 2 years into THL. We have Chewy. Welcome.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
Right. We are happy to have you, and alongside Chewy, we have someone who's also been around, I believe, for about 2 years himself. They have quite the amount of teams they've played on, and so a well-traveled player among THL and someone who I have clashed with a couple of times. We have Judo Chop.
Hello. How is everybody?
I'm doing pretty well. I
We're chilling, Judo.
yeah, it's bright and early. I am nowhere I'd rather be. All right. So as always, I will be. I'll do a short interview. I'll just ask you. I'll ask you a. I'll ask a question for both of you. A question for each of you, and we can get playing some trivia. So I'll start with a question for both Chewy and Judo Chop. Certain players have favorite expansions, for playing the game. Some people have favorite expansions for themes. I'm wondering what. What a Hearthstone expansion did you have the most fun playing the game? That you the like, yeah, the expansion that you've enjoyed playing the most.
Chewie, you want to go first on this?
You can go first.
You need to consult your
refresh.
brain.
Yeah, a little bit.
All right. So I'm just gonna go ahead and say classic
Okay.
day one mid game hunter.
A person after my own heart.
Deadly Shot, Kill Command, Animal Companion.
I think I have like several. I
Yeah.
like the Baron's meta because like that was the first time I qualified for Master Tour.
Oh, nice, yeah.
I love the Garrison meta with the Jace and stuff. I love the Highlander meta. Was really fun. If I Tend to go favorite. I'd probably say like the Gadgetzan Old God era of cards. I think.
Oh, nice. So I imagine you'll be enjoying this this season of Twist. Then
I probably will. I have to buy. I have to buy my cards back because.
Oh
I
no!
Have, yeah. I have deleted a lot of cards from Goblins and Gnomes up until like Frozen Throne.
Ah, gotcha.
But yeah, it's gonna be fun when I get the money.
Yeah, both of those eras that you talked about were two of my favorites as well. Right. So I guess for Judo Chop specifically, something that I know and the people in Czech all know about is your affinity for music that you have like done things like recording local musicians and things like that. Do you have a particular go-to or at least like I'll say like one or two genres of music that you kind of go to for listening?
Well, I kind of like all genres, you know, mm-hmm. as long as they're okay. good. But yeah. I'm kind of jaded in that, like, it's almost like when I'm watching a movie or a TV show, I'm very taken out of the experience because I've been behind the wall on, you know,
yeah.
like, literally sound is in everything, and if it's
yeah.
not recorded on the spot, it's put it in post, you know, so stuff like that. Mm-hmm. But for the sake of telling this story, I'm gonna say classic rock, because one time when I was working as a stagehand, I got to work with Artemis Pyle, the drummer, the original Lynyrd Skynyrd, who, oh, and the nice. Only surviving member of that plane crash. I did a gig with him once, and he told me I did a great job, and like I was like, wow. So, yeah. And hip hop.
Yeah. Yeah, no, that's a fantastic story, and that's a wow moment for sure. If I've ever heard of one. Let's see. So I mentioned for Chewy that he's participated in a lot of esports things. He's made Masters Tour events. He topped 16, won. I guess I'll ask. What type of hobbies, I guess, do you have kind of outside of Hearthstone, or is Hearthstone kind of like has been a lot of your life for the last couple of years?
I was doing archery until I hit
sure.
Age 17, because I broke my right shoulder.
Oh.
And then I couldn't rehabilitate enough to get back to where I was before.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm a floorball goalkeeper. Which I've been for like 7 years now, 6 years.
Oh, very cool.
So I started late, but still going. It's fun. It's like hockey, but on land in a
yeah
in a court.
Oh, very cool. I guess I'll see if maybe Bone Master has anything he'd like to ask. Before we wrap this up, and if not, we can just get right into the next section.
I'll jump in with a question for both of you. What is your favorite THL series to play? Like we've got one, two, three, four now. Five if you got Wild. I don't recognize you guys too much from Wild, but your favorite THL series to play? So Hero, Legacy, Wild, and we've got Trios now as well. Pro. Yeah, five yeah. series.
For me, it's Pro.
Pro.
Hands down.
I mean, I played Legacy. I mean, not Wild last season. I bricked. And as Legacy is kind of the only other thing I play other than trios, but for the sake of Geranium's Purple Heart, I'm gonna say, not Wild. What's Hero? Because I was on a Hero team, and I've since to be recruited to one, and I would just like to play that format again. It was fun.
Awesome.
Very cool.
No, that's all I had. So if we're all ready to get into the trivia, mm-hmm. we can move in there, and I'll get Dankus Dad to tell us what are our six categories today that we can choose from for trivia.
All right, so let's get those up on the screen, Bone Masher, but we've got some good ones today. We've got League of Explorers, Brute Me Dude, Board Control, and then I'm going to need a little help here because I actually am...
Oh, I've also got...
Oh, you've got it on the sheet? Okay, great.
I've got it on the
sheet. And then we've got Oh Captain, My Captain.
Yep.
Going First.
Yeah.
And Crazy Eight. So, lots of good choices here. And then we have a mystery final round, as always.
Of course.
So, nice.
Let me now consult the Oracle here and determine who will have the first choice this week. All right. This time our winner is Judo Chop. So, okay. Judo, where are we going first?
Oh, Captain, My Captain.
Alrighty.
Okay.
So, pretty straightforward category here. We're talking about Hearthstone cards. So, you just have to identify the captain. It's that easy. All right. So, as usual,
How do I, like, is there you... Do I just say my name when I have an answer?
I'm going to ask the question, and then you're going to have 30 seconds or so to DM me an answer. And then after that, we'll just go over the question, and we'll move through the category that way.
Okay. Got you.
All right. So question number one. This captain summons three pirates from the deck. You just have to name the card.
I think I have the name right. I know the card. Don't know the captain's name.
Ready, 10 seconds. And time. All right, unfortunately for Twitch chat, it was not Captain Drekthar, but Chewy, who do we got?
Captain Hooktusk.
Yep.
Nice. So, points for Chewy and Azalea here.
Chewy and Azalea, yep.
And we'll go on to our next one.
You can do them in any order, Dankus. You can leave the one for last.
I'm shaking it up. Captain can go face the turn it is played.
I think I got this one.
Has to be.
Right. 10 more seconds. And time. All right, Chewie and Azalea have it again, but Azalea, who's our captain?
That would be the one and only, what Pat used to call Captain GVG, Captain Galvangar.
That's right. So, can get charge and go face. So, that's two captains down, but we still got three more to go.
My first thought was the same as Geranium's.
I thought it was Captain, like, Hogger. What was that one, like?
Who got points this time? Hogger.
Azalea and Chewie.
Thank you.
Yeah, you know, like Captain Hogger from Battlegrounds.
No, I thought there was like, I thought that was the one with charge. I don't know. Like I said,
we're thinking Mr. Smite, maybe.
Yeah.
But that's Smite, that's no captain.
Yeah, and that's his father's name anyway. All right, here we go. I'm just gonna let you know that throw him under the bus here. Bone Masher wrote this category, so if you're upset with the puns, you can go after him. This captain has hat envy. Other pirates are in aura.
Wait, what? This captain has what?
Hat envy.
Hat envy.
Other pirates are in aura.
Sorry, my dog was howling again.
The hat envy may be in reference to flavor text on the card.
Yes. Well, I can say that the pun did not do enough psychic damage to stop everyone. We have one correct answer in so far. So, give the rest of you another 15 seconds or so.
What was the question again?
This captain has hat envy. Other pirates are in aura. And with that, I'm going to call it there. Once again, points for Chewie and Azalea. Chewie, who is our captain this time?
Love the captain.
That is correct.
Yeah, the first part,
the captain that has our hats.
Hook Tusk has one on
does
the
she?
Card. Yeah.
Oh yeah, she does.
Yeah, but also the thing that I focused it on the second part because I was like aura, like because yeah. I imagine you're trying to say like everyone's in awe, but you said aura, so like
exactly.
But I was like, okay, this is a captain card that gives off an aura effect.
The flavor text for the card is that he has hat envy. It's in the flavor text for South Sea Captain.
Okay. Yeah. I don't usually read flavor text, guys.
you gotta start. It might help you
if
in later.
If you're coming onto the show, any future guests, read flavor text.
There's so many cards for me to read because I'm on every week.
But listen. If you use deck tracker and you hover your cards in hand, they will show you the flavor text.
Sure, they will.
Chewie gets it, yeah.
Chewie knows, yeah.
Alrighty. So we have two perfect scores so far. Let's put an end to this.
Yeah.
Alright.
This captain is rewarded by killing their foe honorably.
That was easy. I don't know how you spell that, but it's probably like that. Right.
Can we phone a friend?
I think it's like that. Maybe.
All right. Time is up, and despite our best efforts, Chewy and Azalea Akari are still taking points here.
I'm still losing.
Yeah, Azalea, yeah. Who is this captain?
It's Knight Captain. Neutral card from the land of honorable kills, Alterac Valley.
That's right. We've got some arena players in the call. Exciting.
Mm-hmm. It was never released to standard, only to arena. Pretty sure.
For all of you to assume I didn't play it to standard.
No, I think even back then, I think we were going through every neutral card in the AFG.
Yeah, it's
in the AFG reviews.
It's an arena card, pretty much like, you know, how some movies go straight to TV.
Yep.
Same thing.
or for most people who might not play Twist or Wild, just like Caverns of Time is straight to Wild.
Yep.
Fantastic set, by the way.
Yes.
All right.
Let's take this category home. This captain is in a rush, but summons a 5/5 defender with taunt as support.
I might have got the name backwards.
All right. Another 15 seconds.
I'm sure if I saw the card that I could, but I can't.
Just like to remind Judo that he chose this category.
Yeah. I didn't even know it was about captain cards. Could have been about THL captains.
All right. And with time called here, Chewy and Azalea have both completed the sweep. Chewy, who's our captain?
Templar captain.
That is correct.
Big Paladin players rejoice.
Yeah.
Templar captain. Yeah.
Alrighty. So with that, at the end of our first category, we've got Azalea, Akari, and Chewy with perfect scores at 5 and Judo Chop with 0. But no one's out of it yet. We still have 2 more categories and a final round to play. So plenty of points on the board.
I do have a tiebreaker question for the final round as well. So getting prepared for that already.
It's getting juicy. And with our next one, Azalea Akari, the board is yours. So where are we going next? I'll remind you that we have Crazy Eight going first, League of Explorers, Brute Me Dude, and Board Control as our remaining categories.
Yeah, League of Explorers.
Alrighty, here we go. We've got another real world one now. You gotta name the explorer.
Okay.
Alrighty. So here we go. I hope you guys were paying attention in your history classes.
Yes, indeed.
So let's kick it off. This Spanish explorer is often referred to as the discoverer of the New World.
Did he actually discover it, or did he not? Or did he just kill 500,000 Caribbeans?
Jeez, Judo. I think you know the answer, but I will say they did not actually. They are referred to.
Okay. Cool. I only say that because those are my people. You know what I mean?
Yep. Alrighty. 10 seconds. Alrighty. And I can close it up a little early because everyone is going home with a point here. Judo Chop, How are you getting this point? Who's this explorer?
This explorer is Christopher Columbus. We all know him. Yep. And the Italians rejoice, but more truthful to the fact is that he discovered the Caribbean and not the United States, as far as I know.
Yeah. Yep. Christopher Columbus sailed the ocean blue, but there's nothing clever there that rhymes with genocide, so they usually
1942.
Yep. So, yeah, with that, we've got 6-6-1, and we go for our next question. This Portuguese explorer was the first European to cross the Pacific Ocean.
Who randomly guess?
It's been 10 years, man. I fuck. Do you need both names?
We're okay. We're good now.
I'm horrible at spelling, by the way.
With that, the tie is broken. Chewie is walking away with our only point here. Chewie, who is that explorer?
Something Magellan. I don't remember his first name.
Poor Ferdinand. Forgotten. But Magellan is good enough, so Chewie takes the lead.
Turanian, why'd you have to say that last? In the last question, you had to answer it with the answer to this question.
Uranium is just naming explorers. I'm surprised that he didn't put Ford in the chat yet, but we'll see. German geographer Martin Waldseemüller coined the name America after this Florentine explorer.
Sorry, I spaced out. What did you say? I didn't hear it.
German geographer Martin Waldseemüller coined the name America after this Florentine explorer.
Wait.
All right. 10 seconds.
I just made up a name.
And time. All right, Azalea, who is it?
It's Amerbucci.
That's right. Listening to chat, finally. Give Azalea and Chewie those points. They've got it.
I was like, I've never heard of this. And then I remembered Uranus' message. And I was like, oh, wait, hold on.
Yeah, I knew America. Like, I was like, you know, who would you name, man? It's got to be America something.
Yeah.
I just put Yiddish.
I learned this. Because when I was a kid, my grandparents, my grandparents had a PC, had like a PC game on there, had a game on the computer that was Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, and this was one of the questions. This was like back in, I'd say early 2000s.
Yeah, my friend had the same game, he loved it.
Yeah.
And so that's how I remember it, that's what I remember it from all these years later.
Well, I can say that for me, we covered 4 out of 5 of these questions in my history classes in school, but
gotcha.
Not this next one. So here we go. This Norwegian explorer was the first to reach the South Pole.
Oh.
Maybe if you're closer to the South Pole, this is common knowledge, but
I don't know this.
Here we will separate the the novices from the true explorers, the true frontiersmen.
Yeah. Well, Australia does have part of Antarctica as their territory, so we're basically Antarctica.
Yeah,
sure. It yep. sure would be a shame if someone here is from the Nordic, wouldn't it?
I'm trying to think of Age of Empires and that. What was that campaign? I'm just gonna go with this.
Yeah, I always played as Genghis Khan, so I can't help you.
Yeah. Well, how would you not want to be Genghis Khan?
Genghis Khan is great, but it is a shame because someone here might be from a Nordic country and have learned this one in history. Chewie, who's our explorer?
Howald Amundsen.
That is correct. And Chewie extends the lead just a bit. Still,
I liked my answer.
Yes. Bran Coldbeard is a good one.
Bran Coldbeard. I was just going for the funnies because I had no clue.
Was Eric the Red even a Nordic explorer?
Yes. He was the guy who discovered America first.
Yes.
Okay. We're staying on a theme here. Okay.
All right. Here we go. The last one of the category. This Portuguese explorer was the first to reach India by sea.
Oh, I learned this too. I don't remember the name.
I know I learned this, but I was in high school 20 years ago.
This is the only one I know, like, immediately. Every time someone says the name explorer, the word explorer, this name just comes to mind immediately. I don't know why.
Well, it's a unique one, and with that, we'll call time. Chewie, who we got?
Vasco da Gama.
That is correct, and
no way I would have remembered that.
With that, Chewie takes the decisive lead, being the first to hit double digits. And after two categories, we have Chewie with a perfect 10, Azalea with 7, and Judah with 1. And
I honestly thought I was going to brick without even not trying. Like trying my hardest, I was still going to get 0. So I got a point. Let's go.
Yeah.
I mean, it was that category was a doozy, but Chewie made short work of it. And Chewie, the board is now yours, so we'll see if your own category is as fortuitous as the other two. We have... Sorry?
Brute me, dude.
All right, we're brooting. So we are back to Hearthstone cards here. You have to name the card with the word brute in its name.
Oh, okay.
This category works out nicely because there are 5 of them. So, away we go. The first ever brute. This card has a 50% chance to attack the wrong enemy.
The classics.
Alrighty, and... everyone was pretty quick to the draw here with the correct answer. So points all around, Bone Masher. Judo Chop, who do we got?
Ogre Brute.
That's right. Alrighty, so you guys have dipped your feet in. We've all got our points. Let's keep going. The inspiration for this category, this Brute has been a key piece of the Quest Demon Hunter archetype. All right, 15 seconds. Right, and we have answers in from everybody. Azalea playing Shaman out here with the lightning reflexes. Who is the Brute?
Ironbound's Brute.
That's right, and points for Azalea. Azalea and Chewie get the points here.
Yeah.
All right.
I may have logged way too many became
so, oh, so many brutes. So many brutes.
Yep. Here we go. The next one. This epic demon deals damage to all enemies whenever it is attacked. All right, 10 more seconds. All right, and with that, Chewy and Azalea have it. Chewy, who's our brute?
Rest by brute.
That is right.
Yep.
All right. And then the next one. A more recent addition to the game. This warrior Naga has taunt and a battle cry.
Oh, I don't know the name. I know everything it does besides the name. Well, because, I mean, you said it, but...
The only reason I know this is because I've discovered it, like, so many times in, like, the past week.
Yeah. I mean, I'm just going to put this. It's wrong, but...
I'll give you a hint. It's got brute in the name.
Yeah, it does have brute in the name. I'm just gonna say this. I know it's wrong. I know everything about it besides the name.
All right. Well,
I'm just picking random words.
Two of our contestants answered Naga Brute, which is not correct. But Chewy, what is the name of this brute?
Black Skill Brute.
Black. That's right. Okay. Black Skill. Point okay, for Chewy. Yeah. It's the type of Naga, yeah.
Yeah.
The tribe.
Then to finish off the category, Enrage Warrior is so back. Well, it would be even more back if it had this rush minion in standard. Wow. Come on, Chewy. At least let me read the question. Humor me a little bit. So fast.
In standard? What do you mean?
No, it's a wild card. In standard.
It is a wild card.
Oh, yeah. It's a wild card. Oh, okay.
Yeah. I don't know the name of it. I'm not going to answer, probably. Not going to get it.
I know.
Okay, it came to my head. Yeah. Yeah, I remember. It was in one of my favorite decks ever.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
I can't think of the name.
Already
yeah. Able to play in the ETC Rush Warrior.
Yeah, ETC right. Rush Warrior. Yep.
Who is it, Chewy?
The Bloodborne Brute.
That's Blood right.
Yeah.
On the board for Azalea and Chewy. And while you might think that we're done here, we have a bonus question.
Yeah, let's go.
So here we go. Those are all five brutes, but one more token exists with brute in its name. Oh, sure. What is the token? And what card creates it? 1 point each.
Oh no! What is the card's exact name?
Look, there's a perfect game on the line here.
I never read token names. That's my problem. Just a token brute.
Yeah.
What?
It's no, funny. I just.
I had no idea.
I was expecting this one to come
I just,
up.
I just looked at my Lurkana deck box and I knew. But I also knew this already.
Alrighty. Five more seconds. Now, Azalea is taking home both points here.
Woo-hoo.
So tell us, Azalea, what is the card and what is the token?
So it's from Build a Snowman. The second minion that you get is the 6/6 Snow Brute.
That is correct.
Right. Yeah. It's, and just for the record, when I said I looked at my Lurkana box, I have Elsa on my box. So
Right, the first one.
Just like she has her marshmallow brute.
Yeah. It's Snowman, Snowbeer, you're right.
Yeah.
So we see our first sign of vulnerability from Chewie, but it is a bonus question, so still at a perfect 15 points.
Still two ahead.
But Azalea is back in the hunt as Bone Masher takes us to our final round. So walk us through it, Bone Masher. What do we got?
All right, so for the final round this week, we will test your knowledge of Hearthstone cards. And the good news is, it costs nothing.
Oh! So, oh no, that's...
you will need to give there's 2 points on offer for each question. One for the name of the card, and one for the condition for why it costs... for when it costs nothing.
The
card, playing the card, whether it's a spell or a minion, costs nothing conditionally. So yeah, the name of the card and the condition. What we'll do is we'll read out the card, some of the card text, or what kind of minion or spell it is, kind of thing. So it'll make sense after the first time or two.
It's not going to be Snowflipper Penguin.
No. So
it is conditional, Bone Masher. If your opponent hasn't played Forensic Duster and you have the card in your hand, it costs zero.
And you have to draw it.
Yeah.
So conditionally, Snowflipper Penguin, in your deck, it doesn't cost zero.
Yeah.
If you don't draw the Snowflipper Penguin, was it ever in your deck? That's
there's so many cards where I've said that.
Schrodinger's Penguin.
Dankus, you can read these out again. I'll chime in as needed.
All right. We'll start off with the first one. A 4-mana 3/4 neutral minion with lifesteal. So I need the card name and the condition.
Sorry, but can you say it again? 4-mana.
A 4-mana 3/4 neutral minion with lifesteal.
Okay. Are all the cards in standard or can it be wild too?
They can be standard or wild.
Okay.
Right. 10 more seconds. All righty. So Chewie and Azalea are both getting their 2 points. Azalea, you were first to the buzzer. Who do we got?
We have Merlocula, who is able to become 0 mana when you infuse 4.
I was thinking Hunter, but I should have known that one. Damn.
All right. With our next one, 7-mana 6/6 neutral minion with taunt.
Oh.
What's his name, bro? 15 seconds.
Oh. I'm just going to write the condition.
I'm hopeless.
Ready, 3, 2, 1, and time. So we have Azalea getting 1 point and Chewie getting 2. Chewie, who's our guy?
Strongman.
That's right.
That's it.
I almost wrote the Circus Strongman.
Ah, yeah. Will it wait in a circus themed deck?
Yeah.
And that condition is corrupt.
Corrupt.
Yeah. You guys were all on the money with that.
So. It's also played in Warlock as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was played in Galakrond Lock.
Yeah.
Tick Lock, of course.
Tick Lock, yeah.
Everyone loves Tick Lock.
Everybody does.
I used to play that deck a lot. I played that in Galakrond Warlock.
Alrighty. Now, we'll keep going. We got the 2-mana Demon Hunter spell that deals 2 damage.
Wait.
Two mana does 2 damage.
So you're... Okay, never mind. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Chewie got it. The light bulb went off. Means I am sad.
Ready. 10 seconds.
There are 8 questions. There's still plenty of time.
Alrighty. And with that, Azalea was correct from their guess. Chewie did figure it out. The light bulb went off. So 2 points for each of them. Azalea, what was our card?
Predation. And the condition is, if you play a Naga while this is in your hand, it costs 0 mana.
That's right.
I got confused because I still think it deals 3.
It's 3 mana, deal 3.
Yeah. The nerfs threw a little wrench in the question.
Yeah.
All right. Now, let's get a little more esoteric here. We've gotten those easy warm-ups out of the way. So now we can really dive in.
I'm ready to get crushed.
We have a 3-mana, 3/3 neutral minion.
Oh my god, what's his name? No, I know exactly which card this is. Oh my god, what's it called? Fuck.
I think I don't know this one.
I had a lot of fun putting this category together. I found some minions that I used to play, and spells that I've played a lot of actually.
Yeah,
this is old school.
I know. Oh my gosh! It just came to me.
10 seconds.
I tried to get Korean.
Alrighty, and that's it. And with the stream of consciousness, Chewie clutched it out at the last second, getting him and Azalea the 2 points. Chewie, who's our minion?
Half the ghoul.
Half.
I knew it was a ghoul, and I knew the condition, but first part just fled me for like ever.
Yeah.
And what was that condition, just for the audience?
If your hero was healed this turn, you equal 0.
That's right.
It was played heavily in Sulu.
Dark Lair.
Yep. Very popular wild card.
Yeah, I knew it from Dark Lair.
Yep. All right. And so we trudge on. Stick to the neutrals. We have a 5-mana 4/4 neutral minion. Alrighty.
I might have slightly missed on the actual effect.
More seconds. All right. And with time, Chewie's taking home 1 point. Just a little bit off on the condition. Azalea, getting two, though. So catching up. Azalea, what do we got?
The card is Arcane Tyrant. And the condition is if you played a spell that costs 5 or more on your turn.
Well, that's what this turn. Yes, and that last part is the key.
It is gotta be
this turn. To write this turn, and oh my god.
Yeah.
I knew it was this turn. It has been invited.
So I said it costs more than 5. I thought you were gonna knock me for that because I didn't say 5 or more.
Yeah,
I but it's I remember that 5. I forgot that 5 cost spells activated it.
God,
even though I knew it in my brain, my fingers did not type that way. Yeah, Arcane Tyrant, big good druid card.
Yeah, it was definitely the most exciting 0 mana neutral minion from Kobolds and Catacombs, right, guys?
Absolutely, right?
There certainly was not another.
I was waiting, I don't know if the category is over, but I was waiting for that card.
Nah, we still have a couple more, don't you worry.
Oh, okay.
We've got a 4 mana rogue spell that deals 4 damage to a minion.
No, whoa. I'm gonna get the name wrong. I'm gonna say this. I'm gonna say this is the name.
Yeah.
I'm gonna put the condition first, and then think of the name.
The name is wrong. The effect is correct. Like my brain just couldn't think of the actual card. Name.
Yep. Alrighty. And we have the 1 point for Azalea, but Chewy is back with 2. Chewy, what do we got?
Vendetta.
That's right. Very close, Azalea. But
yeah.
And in that condition?
Cost 0 if you're holding a card from another class.
Yep.
Most conditions for rogue.
Yes.
Yeah. So I will say for the record, I put Vengeance as the card name. So I was close.
Yeah. That's more Demon Hunter sounding, but...
Yeah, it does sound more Demon Hunter. Or Visage. Or Visage. Yep. That's probably where my brain probably, like, has seen Vengeful Visage quite a bit.
Yes.
So, yeah.
All right. Here we go. 2 more left. We've got a 5 mana 3/5 druid minion with taunt.
Oh!
Alrighty, and with that, Azalea and Chewie are getting 2 points each because we cannot fool Chewie twice. What is this one, Chewie?
Anubis of the Moon.
In that condition?
Costs 0 if you cast a spell that costs 5 or more this turn.
Yep. On the money.
On the money. Yeah.
And there we go. Alright.
It's an Arcane Tyrant, but the taunt.
Yes.
Yeah, better Arcane Tyrant.
All right, and our final question.
I don't know. Arcane Tyrant is an elemental, so, with
okay.
Oh yeah,
it's better than Arcane. It's better in Druid than Arcane Tyrant was in Druid. Obviously, I know it's a Druid card.
Yeah.
Tyrant could be played in Mage.
It's true.
Yeah. But we're sticking to the theme of Druid for one more. We've got a 2-mana Druid spell that gives a minion +1/+3 and taunt.
It's this guy.
Said it was 2-mana.
Yep.
Yes.
Not when I play it.
I don't think I've ever played that for 2-mana.
Yeah.
I might have. Right. I might have like once or twice. I don't remember.
Five more seconds, and I can say no, I have.
I got it.
I definitely have.
Yeah.
All right. Time.
Yeah.
Time. Azalea and Chewy are taking home 2 points each. And Azalea, what's our card?
Ironbark.
That's right.
And the condition is if you have 7 or more mana crystals.
Yep.
The card costs 0.
The more famous Bog Beam did not make the quiz. Instead, Bone Masher went a little more off the beaten path.
I like that call. I was actually waiting. Yeah.
Yeah.
So when you mentioned this, I thought of three cards immediately. I thought of Murlocula, I thought of Corridor Creeper, and I thought of Ironbark.
Can't believe Corridor Creeper was named, to be honest.
Technically it's one of those cards that like counts down to 0 cost.
All
of the cards.
Wisdom of Narga, just like Wisdom of Narganon.
All of the cards specifically have this costs in brackets 0 on the card. So,
consistency. Yeah.
Okay. I mean, but Corridor Creeper is infused before infused existed.
Yeah,
it's true.
True.
They could have wrote infused 7.
Well, they couldn't have though, because Corridor Creeper was better than that.
Yeah, it was.
Because other minions infused it too.
Sure. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah, you're right. Everything.
Corridor Creeper was pretty cheap.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now, just for fun, we don't have a tie, but we'll have one more question for our trivia enthusiast today. Just for fun. No points, but the tiebreaker. Including the original, how many cosmetic coins are there in Hearthstone?
Oh no, I've seen this question before too. Wait, no.
Including the original?
Including the original.
Are we including gold versions or only the normal versions?
Only the normal versions.
So if you gold, you have to have the gold deck to have the gold version.
If you go into your collection and you want to set your favorite coin, how many of them are in there as options? That's
yes. So we'll see who's closest to the pin.
There's so many.
20 seconds. Ten seconds. All right, and we have an answer from everyone. So we'll start with the furthest and work into the closest. All right. So furthest from the mark here was Judo Chop. Judo, what was your answer?
14.
And 14 was not a bad guess. Still, from what I would say, sort of in the ballpark. Next closest, we've got Azalea. So,
I put 20. I said 22.
Very, very close, but not as close as Chewy, whose guess was
exact
24,
which is the correct answer.
Yeah, Chewy there's been two expansions since last one. So I messed it up by two.
What was Chewie's answer?
24 coins, which is on the money.
On the money, correct, yeah. I forgot about that. I didn't add this expansion.
Well, yeah. But great trivia showing everybody.
Absolutely.
You know, so Chewie just goes on. Mr. Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Mr.
Oh, you've seen that?
Yeah, oh, of course. Jordan can't do all the questions on his own, right?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I got the coins question from Jordan asking it to somebody. Jordan MG asking it in one of his videos. Yeah, I didn't know the answer.
But... Yeah, I wonder who Jordan asked. Who could have won that video? G.
Oh.
If only they were here.
Oh, it's Chewy. Oh. Okay.
But yeah.
I hope I didn't disappoint, but at least I educated people on the history of the Caribbean a little more.
Oh, yeah.
That's my one point.
Two, actually.
You got two.
Yeah.
And thanks to all of you for coming on. This was a ton of fun, as usual, and you guys were great contestants and great guests.
I want you to just keep my lowest score as the record. Is this the record for the lowest score?
For now. It's holding it for now.
So far, yeah.
Yeah. Let's go.
But that's actually a misnomer, because you know who has the lowest score? All of you at home who have not been on the show yet. So if you're interested in getting out of that hole and trying to hit that 2 points, if you think you can do better, please reach out to me, Bone Masher, or Azalea. We'd love to have you and another partner on the show. So, yeah, get in here. It's a lot of fun. And, yeah, if you're looking to play, come on down.
Yeah, we do have guests lined up for next week. But after that, we are looking for people. So, yeah, just hit us up. And if the time doesn't quite work, just hit us up anyway, and we'll see what we can do to do a time outside of our normal time. But either way, we are looking for people. So, let us know. With that, congrats again to Chewy for taking out the trivia this week. Just a bit of housekeeping for THL. We've got match shows on Friday nights, Saturday nights, and Sunday nights. So reach out to Wild Nine or Saku in the usual channel match requests. We also have the THL shows, so Sidebar and Her Center missed shows last week, so they'll be doing double weeks this coming Tuesday. Sidebar in the morning at 8 a.m. Eastern, and Her Center at 9 p.m. in the evening Eastern time. We also have the THL blog, which has got Diamonds articles talking with captains at the moment, and also an article that went out from Righteous Jammies as well about some decks. So we've got a couple of blog posts going. We've also got both Twitch and THL memberships as well. So if you'd like to support THL, then you can do that as well. And you can even use your Twitch Prime, which costs nothing with the theme tonight. Once again, thank you, Chewy and Judo Chop, for being on the show. Did you have any last words before we wrap up?
Thank you.
See you Prime again. Costs your soul. I'm sorry, did I cut you off, Chewy?
No, it's fine.
And thank you to my co-hosts, Dankestad and Azalea Akari. Any last words for tonight?
No, nothing here. Just have a great day, everybody, and tune in for Salty Saturday later.
Indeed. Yeah,
please give us matches for Salty Saturday. I don't believe we have any.
Yeah, make Wild Nine work, guys. Come on.
Yeah.
Wait.
I actually wonder if this is the week where he's out. I think Wild Nine mentioned that he's away.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
He was away this week, yeah.
Yeah.
I think I remember.
So unless somebody is willing to opt for me, and other casters, we won't have a salty Saturday.
Sunday showdown, we have a match.
I don't know if I'm approved to op, but I would if you needed one.
Yeah, we'll see. We don't have any matches lined, but I know that. I know it seems like there is a desire from Neji to get Dredeye and Banter on stream. So we'll see how that goes.
Yeah, we can take that offline. All right, that's it for us tonight. Once again, if you want to reach out to get on the show, otherwise, have a good day, everyone. Good night.
Yeah.
Thanks, everyone. Bye.
Thank you.
All right, that was a good show.
Yeah.